Are we back?
Yeah, we are going to continue Treasure's storyline. We're on mission 20?
23.
Mm-hmm. And if this is the first time you've watched us, we've been trying to do all the storyline in order, and we are at level 75 on purpose to try to make it a little bit more engaging. Even though so far Treasure's has mostly been just story, not much combat.
Mostly cutscenes, yep.
Mostly cutscenes, yeah.
I'm just changing my job really quick, back to level 75.
We started these characters back in, like, last December. I've been documenting our journey, even though when we first started, my sound equipment wasn't very good. And I've since upgraded everything on my computer, so it sounds a lot better than it did. Are we going to Whitegate?
Yes. Whitegate 1. On my way. Just changed jobs.
It's always been my goal to complete the story in this game. I've been playing for 20 years, but back in those days, I mostly just was concerned about playing with friends and
leveling.
It took me a year to get that 75 job. So, but now the game has changed where I can spend more time on the story, take my time, and me and her can just play at our own pace.
It was really fun. So far beating ZM and COP and Dynamis. Now we're doing Treasures, and then we'll do Abyssia and Wings and Adeline, and then the three, like, Shintoto Ascensions. It'll be fun.
Where'd you go?
Up here. I'm waiting on you.
The game teleports.
Yeah. You, like, skipped way ahead. Ho ho! You've nothing left to prove. It's time for me to make my move. Thank you, Ambassador. I greatly appreciate your stance as a woman of action.
I've never seen anyone enjoy chatting with President Najah quite so much before. Why do I feel a chill down my spine?
How absolutely wonderful! A branch office in the Middlelands, and with the Star Sibyl's approval. Oh, don't give me all the credit. Noxian Rewind's performance in the execution chamber convinced me of your company's merit. And with mercenaries such as these wandering the street, our lackluster Mithra soldiers will learn to stop dragging their feet. Though she was nothing more than a wall to prevent me from taking any damage at all. Of course, and you know, this mercenary is merely the tip of the iceberg for the talent we have here at Salaheim Sentinels. Oh ho ho. What is your proposal? How will you run this venture with the resources at your disposal? Well, we'll have to start with choosing a location, designing the offices, hiring staff.
President?
Ordering weapons, training the troops, negotiating with the Federation Army.
President Najah?
What? Can't a girl plan in peace?
That's a lot of work. I wonder if I-Bomb will be able to handle everything over there by himself.
You're right. Oh ho, you seem to have encountered a snag. I do hate when things like this start to drag. Abkuba!
Yes, ma'am?
How many people do you have working here? And tell me their registration numbers, would you, my dear?
That information is confidential, you see.
Quickly now. Surely you don't intend to make an ambassador scrape and bow.
Oh dear, my poor heart. Please remember, this is top secret.
Oh ho, so many. And what is the number of my shield, pray tell me?
Oh, that would be...
Such an easy number to recall. I have no more reason to stall. Using the employee registration numbers, I will attempt to divine who is it and who is exempt. A divination? That's correct. It's an ancient Windurstian art with results that are near perfect. This song will choose the person you need with amazing accuracy and surprising speed. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Catch a tiger by the toe. If he hollers, let him go. Cast the spell, and you will know. That's her master spell. And there it is, the registration number of who will become your business whiz. And who is it, Ambassador? Who is the lucky mercenary? Oh ho ho.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh? That number belongs to Noxie and Rewind.
I knew it.
I should have guessed. Oh, are you sure this mercenary can handle such a huge responsibility? Oh, I'm sure she'll be fine. The mercenary you refer to as your shield is our number one ace. Even the Empress has granted her an audience.
Is an Empress higher rank than King? And you say this mercenary is an ace? This cannot be.
An audience with the Empress. How impressive. If you relate that story, you'll find me quite attentive. Avjang. Nijing's a boy.
Where has she gone? What could she be doing? Who do I turn to? Who do I trust? What do we do? Avjang. Tell me.
Yes, once everyone heard the story, the applications have just been rolling in.
And President Naja made sure everyone heard the story.
And it's all thanks to Noxie and Rewind here. So, you see, sending her off to a foreign land would be like losing an arm. It would break my heart to see Noxie go. But if she were willing to expand the company and build a new office in Windurst... Oh ho, I understand the point of your speech. Who would have guessed that the Empress was within their reach? Huh? Well, yes, I too was rather impressed. Her value in this land is beyond calculation. Oh, I would never wish to damage your solid foundation. I must rethink this offer of an office in our land. What? Why, didn't you dismiss it yourself out of hand? Losing her would be like the loss of a limb. I couldn't deprive you of that on a whim. No, I was just being...
I have your refusal stored in my memory banks.
Hold on there. Such a shame. I envisioned your company protecting our nation. Thalahim's sentinels would have been our salvation. But I would never dream of ruining your bond. That couldn't be fixed by just waving a wand.
Lady Karababa, your compassion knows no bounds.
Ambassador, you don't mean to tell me our deal is off. We must shift our planning back to square one. Now we really must go. Our business is done.
You see him freaking out back there?
Yes. Just a darn minute. We have a banquet to attend. No time for further delay. The Grand Vizier is not a man I wish to dismay.
Yes, arriving late would be a terrible insult.
So very true. Once again, my good people, I bid you adieu.
Oh dear, oh dear.
Abquaba?
Yes, ma'am.
Hit me a bag of Simsim. Throw them all along this line, without a break.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Private Second Class. Looks like you did a fine job of guiding and guarding. You heard the ambassador singing your praises, didn't you? You must be thrilled. And I suppose you're expecting the same sort of Gunshin compliments from your president, hmm? Well, that ain't gonna happen. I can't even stand to look at your smug face right now. Get out of my office and out of my sight. Or I'll tenderize your hide and have mercenary steaks for dinner. Okay, so we have to zone, and then we have to wait until the next Vanity L day to talk to her again for the next cutscene. So we can either, like, level a job for a little bit, or we can try assault here to try to rank up, maybe. What do you think? What would you like?
Story.
Can't do that.
Why not?
That's what I just said. We have to zone and wait till the next Vanity L day to get to the next cutscene.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
God, I hate that.
Me too.
I mean, just pause it, I guess.
Okay.
That's lame.
Yeah.
I don't really care about doing the assault and stuff.
You don't want to try it?
I mean, we can try it, but... Do I need to be like 99 jobs to do that? Because 75 might be too hard?
Yeah, we'll need to switch to our 99 job to try it.
What's the point of doing it, really?
I think you get currency for Abyssia that you can use to buy level 75 weapons that are like really, really, really good. Here's a solo assault guide.
It's going to be another 30, 40 minutes until the next day.
Yeah. You have a 30-minute time limit. For when you clear an assault for the first time, you get 5 mercenary rank points. If you get all 5 assaults for your current rank, you get to be promoted.
Well, I'm going to pause it for 1 second, okay?
Okay.
So, we are... actually, back on a new day. Yesterday, we had to wait an hour or something, and I was tired, and I was kind of cranky. So we went to bed, and we are back, and I spent most of today re-EQing our mics. So I might sound different, and she might sound different. Hopefully it's not too bad. Hopefully it sounds more natural. I hope so. That's the goal anyways. I don't want the voices to sound irritating. So if you're watching... and you want to leave a comment and let me know, hey, your EQ sucks, that's fine. I can take it. I can work on it. I'm trying to improve. I've been trying to improve for the last year and a half since I started doing this channel, so I appreciate you. I'm going to pause it. She is almost ready to play. Yeah, like I said, this is a continuation of yesterday, because yesterday it made us wait like a Vanity L day, and we're like, nah, I'm good. I'm gonna have some cereal and watch some TV. Know what I'm saying?
Right.
You feel me?
I feel you.
So, like I said, we have brand new EQ, and I hope to God it doesn't sound like crap.
I'm sure it won't sound like crap.
But you have to talk really close to the mic now.
But I am.
Now you are.
I have been.
Where to?
Whitegate 1. Did you zone, though? Because I zoned yesterday, did you? You have to zone before you can get this next cutscene.
Oh. I guess I'll... head somewhere else. because I don't think I did zone.
I don't think you did. I think you were just frustrated that you had to wait, so you just, like, logged off.
I quit. I yield. I forfeit. I'm out of here. I'm tired of shit.
Oh my gosh, I just saw a shout for mygillshop.com. Get fast delivery.
Kiss my ass. I hate gill sellers.
It's been a thing for the past 20 years.
I don't know. I mean, I know people are get lazy and whatever, but... And now a lot of people who play 11 are probably older and have jobs and careers and 401ks, and they can afford all that gill. But back when they were younger, they had to work at McDonald's and spend half their paycheck on some gill so they can afford their hobby.
Right.
With their scorpion harness. You teleported.
And it looks like you're still over by the crystal.
I'm hurrying.
There you are.
I'm running. I like how we have headsets on that are very sensitive. I can hear you burp. Even if you're really quiet about it.
Like, I was like...
I heard... Burp.
I was like super polite about it. Jeez, I didn't think you would hear that.
You have to turn away from the mic for a second when you do your burps, honey.
I'm sorry.
You hear your farts. You...
Hey, I did not do that.
That's me. Sexy. She bored?
Yeah.
That's a good shot for all your Mithra lovers out there.
A sweet deal always has a sting.
What is
How could
doing?
I, of all people, have forgotten that? That pompous, money-grubbing ambassador. Speaking of money, Apkoba.
Yes, ma'am. She finally remembered I existed.
She received payment from that arrogant ambassador for Noxian Rewind services.
No, I didn't. Oh, no, maybe... Maybe being forgotten was healthier.
Unbelievable. How could I have been so sucked in that I forgot to collect a fee? Grr. If I don't do something about this, I'll never live it down.
Uh-oh.
Right. Noxie! That Tarutaru was so impressed with your skills that has yet to pay a single gill in remuneration. And so, you're going to trot over to here, to her, and pick up that reward. Stop it. He's assaulting me.
I'm trying to put her mouth in front of the microphone.
Well, yesterday you said I was being too loud, and now you're like, no,
you're
closer.
Now you're being too quiet.
Well, make up your mind. If you manage to appropriate the money... I'll let you keep every single coin. Just one thing. If you fail, it'll mean death for our professional image. I don't care how rough you get, but don't come back without that cash. Apkoba, you know what to do.
Yes, ma'am. According to Gesho, the ambassador has finished her business with the Grand Vizier and is preparing to return to her homeland. And if y'all didn't watch us before,
I
gave him a Texan accent. Which means you better hurry. Apkoba is a cowboy.
Yes. The occasion of an ambassador's plenipotentiary's departure should be marked with pomp and circumstance. And yet, not a single person has bothered to make an appearance.
That is not true, Lady Karababa. My sensors detect many spectators...
Spectators
hiding in the shadows.
What a charming send-off indeed. Well, I'm not going to plead.
Your magical tantrum at the banquet last night may have scared off well-wishers.
Oh, well, they refused to allow me to see the Empress. You can't blame a girl for releasing a little stress.
What kind of person is the Empress? I have had no contact with her yet.
It doesn't matter. We were able to greet that other girl and hear her chatter.
Oh, The one with the malfunctioning friends?
If they were unable to penetrate my disguise, their automaton technology has hit lows rather than highs.
Ha ha ha, you are unforgiving, Lady Karababa. Your shield has returned to your side.
Oh ho ho, isn't this exciting? This nation is on the brink of evolving and changing, no matter if they wish it or not. That girl in Noxie will eventually upset the pot. Ho ho ho. Oh yes, you must be feeling ignored. I have completely forgotten to give you your reward. King, give Noxie her due. We mustn't neglect to say thank you.
Yes, ma'am. I receive 5 Imperial Gold Pieces.
You must understand, your reward is not for guiding me about this foreign land. These are campaign funds to continue the task you've been set. I trust you're not the type to suddenly forget. I'm sure you remember your duty, and have not been swayed by some Near Eastern beauty. The main goal of my trip to this distant shore was to send Ottergon's secluded politics into uproar, and to gather the reins of control to some extent. Thanks to you, I've succeeded 100%. Ancient technology in mechanical puppets and an unlawful organic weapon entrepreneur, I must say this has been quite the tour. But any country has its share of underhanded dealings. I'm hardly overcome with fear and anxious feelings.
Yes, that chimera soon fell to your mighty spells.
And that is why I realize the astral candescence is the threat that is nigh.
How unfortunate you weren't able to obtain it last night. Pesky serpent generals.
It's probably for the best. Who knows what effect the astral wind might have had on the star tree and all the rest. Noxie, rewind. Continue to build your reputation in the Empire, so you might dig deeper for the information we require. And try to meet again with the puppeteer and her toys. You might find you'll hear more than just banter and noise.
Oh, I forgot to put on my my background. There we go. Those junk puppets have ties to the palace?
Speak to Rodan Comedian when you need to contact me. He's easier to find thanks to his sheer stupidity. Oh ho ho. Thought I saw something flying up there.
Was he spying on us?
Yeah.
That mercenary is a spy, huh? She's craftier than she looks. Things are getting mighty interesting.
Ooh, cool music.
Uh-oh.
Sounds like Game of Thrones.
That must be the ship everyone talks about.
The ghost ship.
The black something.
Black coffin.
Sounds like an emo band.
Yeah, it does.
Dark Rider. It seems I am not alone. He's a cool character model. I'd totally be that character.
Oh, totally.
You obtain 5 Imperial Gold Pieces.
Oh, man. We have to zone and then wait till the next Vanna DL day to talk to Nausea.
What the hell?
Not even kidding.
The
yeah.
Hell treasures.
And I really wanted to play longer. Couldn't we try one assault or something?
Well.
Let me get my sanction.
I started a cussing. What the hell happened here?
Oh, why'd you talk to her?
I have no idea. I thought I was getting Signet. Or whatever. Now it's like a Galka with a pumpkin head. I guess we can start Bastok or something.
Or Abyssia.
Is it close to being the next day?
No, it's only 9.
Oh, man. That's kind of mean to make you wait hours there.
It really is, because the last mission did that to us.
Wow.
So mission 24 and mission 25 both make you wait until the next Vanadil day.
And we already beat all the Dynamis zones.
Mm-hmm. So we could start Abyssia?
I kind of want to start Abyssia like when it's like when we're to that point. Bastok's really the only old storyline we've missed.
That's true.
You want to go start it?
We can. You sure you don't want to try an assault?
I am sure.
I really want to try it.
I'll come assault you. Get the cops called on us and have a domestic dispute. I don't want to put that microphone in front of your mouth. You refuse to talk. You're supposed to talk in front of it. Not in the side, in the front.
I am trying. Let me look up.
Bastok.
Let's see. In Metalworks? 1.
Do you call it Bastok?
Or no. Bastok? It is Bastok.
Bastok. They say Bastok in the intro cutscene.
Right? Well, we all know that's not, you know.
Bastok. I like Najee. He's my favorite character.
Yeah, I like Najee too.
Are they first right now? No, they're last. This is going to be cheap to switch. If they're third place, it's the cheapest.
Mm-hmm. I don't think it's there. It says a room next to the president's office. So maybe in here. Nope.
Mythly. Nope. That's mythly. You can apply here to change your allegiance to blah 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 blah. We will have to steal away your memories. Yada yada. We've been there, done that before.
Yep.
You ready?
Sure. Do it.
Our last nation. I need a break from Treasures anyways. Okay, Treasures is... It's funny, but... Ugh.
It is. The cutscenes are just really long.
It's getting better, though.
Oh, yeah. They're really interesting, and I really like the humor, and I like all the characters.
It started really slow.
Mm-hmm.
Really slow.
It
and
did.
And then now it feels pretty funny.
Yeah, it's good. I just wish they wouldn't make us wait.
I know, right? In the Gusseberg Mountains of southern Quan lies the industrial nation known as the Republic of Bastok. Compared to Sindoria with its legendary orders of knights and Windersh, this ancient magic, Bastok is still a newborn nation. But advanced technology and near limitless underground resources have allowed Bastok to rival the other two nations in power. Innovative and adaptable humans make up more than half the population of Bastok. With their flair for industry, economy, and politics, they were the driving force behind Bastok's rapid growth. Even now, humans hold key positions in those areas. You have to read really fast. The Galka, a race of hulking humanoids, comprise a third of Bastok's population, originally hailing from Zapwell. They came to this land over 600 years ago. Without their incomparable strength, the countless ore mines that drive Bastok's economy would never have been dug. Adventurers seeking fame and fortune flock to rising nations like Bastok. You are one of them. Your story begins here, amid the smoke and bustle of the industrial city of Bastok. I have to read uncomfortably fast.
Right?
I hate reading that fast. Excuse me. How do I get to the residential area? Hello, I'm new in Bastok. Can you tell me where the residential area is? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize you were new here, too. I guess I'll have to find my way there myself. People aren't too friendly around here, are they? Anyways, good luck to the both of us. Pesky Hume. Where does he think he is? Windurst? Someday this is turning out to be. You're not from around here either, huh? No use denying it. I can smell it. If you don't want to get hurt, turn around and go back where you came from.
Hey, hey, there's no need to be rude.
Since when do you care about what happens to outsiders, Gumpa?
I'm just saying that one such you shouldn't bother with... I said that wrong. I'm just saying that one such as you shouldn't bother with their, like, oh, great warrior, D-Dog.
He said that weird.
Whatever. You just remember, outsider. I won't go easy on you next time.
D-Dog is mean. Sorry about that. People can be so hard-headed around here sometimes. Hey, why the glum look? Don't like being talked to like some new recruit? But it is your first time here, isn't it?
Nope.
Really? Well, you still look like you haven't been around much. Is there anything you want to know? Anything you want to do? Maybe I can point you in the right direction.
Fight monsters.
Then you shouldn't have to come into the city in the first place. Go back the way you came from and pass through the south gate. That'll take you outside. Oh, and make sure you always check monsters out before you fight them. You don't want to pick fights with things you can't beat. Like D-Dog.
Like D-Dog.
And take this adventure coupon. Arva should give money for it. A whole, like, 10 gil or something.
Hey, it's 50 gil.
50. Don't worry. It's not mine. I just found it. Arva should be around here somewhere. Here. And he's telling me tutorials. Kind of cute. Like, we're starting a new character.
I'm standing right by Arva if you want to give her your adventurer coupon.
I'm going to be rich. At least I can pronounce her names here. I'm like,
right?
Sandoria.
An adventurer coupon. Good. Here's your starting gil. You would do well to speak with a man named Guldago. You can find him by the west gate in Bastok Market.
A whole whopping 50 gil.
Whoa.
And we're Karababa's secret agent. That's our title right now. This is our last nation to do. We started the game last year with Winders, and then we just beat Sandoria not that long ago, maybe a month or two ago. And now here we are, starting all over again. We've never done all three nations on one character before.
Nope.
We did them in separate characters.
Okay, Signet first.
Maybe we'll get lucky and we'll find some fetish on the auction house. This is your first time going on a mission, is it not? Your first assignment is not a difficult one. The details are as follows. You must go to the Zirin Mines in the western section of the Mines District. Once here, you are to collect the report from the Overseer. You can consult the mission section of the main menu to review your objectives. Speed and efficiency are your priorities. Dismissed! Snake, you have to press the action button.
All right.
What's the action button? Damn. Meryl.
Oh, you're so funny. Okay, Bastok mission. We are on the Zerun report. All right.
It's not over yet, Snake.
Liquid. Liquid.
I love the music here. It is so nostalgic.
It's so nostalgic.
Yes. Did you just make fun of me?
No.
Sure sounded
like
it.
I don't make fun of anyone. I just repeat stuff like a parrot. Like the parrot from Metal Gear Solid 2.
Hal? Hal?
E-E!
Hal? Hal?
I'm like, someone shoot that damn bird.
I know, because every time the bird talks, he cries.
I love how if you have the soldiers talk in front of the parrot or something, the parrot starts talking like the soldiers. He starts repeating them.
Yeah, that is really cool.
Little stuff
little
like that is what makes
Kojima
Metal
Game.
Gear so great.
Yeah, for sure.
It's little things.
Yep.
MGS2 had a bad rep for its crazy storyline, but I think the older we get, the more we appreciate it and how he predicted the
for
future.
For sure, yeah.
Oh, it's crazy. At the time, I was like, this is stupid. Internet's kind of a thing. You go on there and no big deal. Now it's like everywhere. He predicted the future.
I know. And like a lot of Kojima's games have predicted the future with Death Stranding. It happened like right before COVID.
Yeah.
But it was about
right before.
Yeah, like right before, like a month before.
Yeah.
And then it's about like everyone being isolated and in their own homes and everyone's afraid to leave and only if the porters leave, you know.
Yeah, we're relying on UPS to bring us our supplies.
Yes, and even getting groceries delivered. And
yeah.
I mean, it was really weird.
Yeah. Or it might go a step further, and we might have World War III, and we all might live in bunkers because it's too inhospitable to live above ground.
Well, I sure hope not.
A soot crab. Or soot, actually, not suit.
Soot.
Soot.
Ah, you must be the courier. I've been expecting you. My report is ready. Be careful on your way out. Remember, you should give my report to Najee, one of the Mithril Musketeers, on post at the President's office.
You want to just warp, or you want to walk?
Sure. Let me put on my warp ring.
We need to change our home point.
Oh, yeah.
Where should we put it in Bastok?
I like Bastok Mines right by the auction house.
Yeah. Bastok 1? Mines 1? There's no book? Well, I guess there is a book there.
Yeah, because there's a book and the auction house and a mog house
and an outpost.
And an outpost
that we will never use.
And the crystal. It has everything.
It was the original best place to be at the auction house one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because back in the day when you have to use outpost warps, that was the place to be.
For sure. Now the only thing that's not there is Unity warp.
I know.
But we don't use it very often.
Yeah.
So I think that's our best bet.
That's true.
And the sparks guy, but...
And it's always a quick teleport away. So
yeah.
Not a big deal.
It's not far.
So make sure you set this as your home point. Wait, no. Wrong button. Man, I hope the EQ is okay. This is our first test run. I've been working on it all day long.
Yes, you tend to do that.
Are we going to the gate guard? Or are we going to Najee?
Najee, but wait for me.
So, mark it. No.
Okay, set this as your home point. Okay, now let's go to Metalworks
1. Metalworks, that's what I was thinking of. This area is off limits to... Oh, you brought the report from the Zero Mines. I'll take that. This was your first mission, wasn't it? Good work. Normally we... Sir Lucius? How may I help you? Najee, you mentioned a report? Yes, sir. The adventurer just brought the last one. I was going to bring them all to you later, sir. Show it to me. So, more and more Galka are starting to believe in their Tellkeeper's return. The Tellkeeper, sir? But I thought that was just some Galka myth, sir. If that were only true, I've received reports that the Tellkeeper is already back among them. These reports, keep bringing them to me, Najee. We would not want to bother the President with such trivial matters. Yes, sir. As for you, adventurer, you have done well. Bastok needs more people like you. Wow,
Not many people get to speak to Sir Lucius, and after their first mission, he must see something in you. Keep up the good work. Is it fetish time?
Not quite yet. Okay, so we need to go to, Mines 1. We'll need to accept the next mission, which is called a geological survey.
Oh yeah, we have to go to
Dangerfwadi.
Dangerfwadi. Dandruff.
Dandruffwadi.
That's 6 hours for a rank one. They must really need our help. The chief engineer is conducting new research and has asked for someone to assist him. He can be found in the metalworks, to the east of the administrative section. The chief engineer's laboratory is on the second floor of the metalworks. You don't know his name? And you call yourself a Bastalker? Or a Bastoker? The chief engineer's name is Sid. Any Bastalker would know that. Now go and see him. He will give you the details of your mission.
These missions are going to be so much faster than if we were a brand new character because of all the teleports that we have.
I know. So, metalworks.
Mm-hmm.
Sid.
I'm over here waiting for you.
I always want to talk to Nanji because he always cracks me up.
Oh, I know, me too. I like his relationship with Ayami.
Yeah, he tries his best. Everyone's so mean to him.
They just like talk down on him because he's like the number 4 Mithril Musketeer.
Yeah. He tries his best. Yeah, what do you want? I'm a little busy right now. Huh, yeah, I'm Sid. Oh, you heard about the mission. Right, I was expecting you. Hey, Raw Bait. Bring the thingamajig over here. This is your only second mission, huh? Well, most of the young ones in Bastok don't have the guts to go adventuring. So I'm counting on you. Do your best, hear? Well, the mission's not all that tough. You just have to go out. Robot, old buddy, if you brought in the Thane, don't just stand there. Say something.
I brought the Thane.
Gah! If you don't quit that, I'm gonna start calling you Silent Mountain or something.
You would not, Chief. You're not like the others. That is why I work for you.
Sheesh. I like the guy. He works hard, but he's thorough in his research and all that, but if only he was a little more talkative, you know? Anyway, here's what I want you to do. Take this blue acidity tester to the Dangriff Wadi near South Gustaberg. Try to find a place in the Wadi where this blue acidity tester changes color. That's all. What's it for? Well, in order for you to understand, I'd have to give you some lessons on the accrual patterns of the sediments in the Wadi and the formation of gas pockets in the soil. You're getting a blank expression on your face. I know, I know. You didn't become an adventurer to study geology, right? Don't worry. It's nothing dangerous. So get going.
I guess that Galka didn't have his Native American-like name.
No.
I thought it was kind of cool Galka had that, but unfortunately, I really wish as a Galka you have two names.
Yeah, and so that you could really roleplay.
Especially if you're a Taru boy with two names.
A hyphen.
Yeah.
They should. Mine's one, so we can use a book to go to Wadi.
You have a lot of HP for a Taru.
Yes, I do. Benefits of being monk.
Gustaberg, I think.
Yes.
Dandruff Wadi, here we go. I didn't upset you earlier by the burp thing, did I?
No.
Okay, good.
I honestly did not realize. I really, really did not think you could hear. So now I'll be like super careful.
I never mean to do that. I just think it's funny. Sometimes I forget that you're a girl.
Right?
I really shouldn't say that stuff.
That's true. Sometimes you embarrass me, but that's okay.
Guys don't think about that kind of stuff. Well, they think about it, like, after it's too late. Like, oh, I shouldn't have said that.
Right.
Oh, no.
Oh, man, I should not have told her her butt looks big today.
But guys like that now.
Oh, yeah.
If you tell a girl her butt looks small, they'll get mad. Back in the day, they'd get mad if you said their butt looks big. But now it's like, oh, thank you. I've been doing squats.
Squats. Or got a Brazilian butt lift.
I'll take one of those.
You look so weird.
The big old butt. Got a hoarder hair. What's he hoarding? Food?
Probably. Carrots.
Yeah, I saw him in the episode of Hoarders. Oh, I wasn't standing in the right spot. There we go.
Alright, check your temporary key items to make sure the acidity tester is now red.
It's red.
We are good to go back.
Wow.
Hard mission there.
Yeah.
It says make sure you grab circumspection from the grounds tome by the entrance.
You have to watch out because some things are really hard here now.
Yeah, they really are, but it's farther up. There's like level 85 mobs in here.
Okay.
Back to Cid.
That's right. Oh, no, no, no. Wrong button. That'll work. It's not even a new day yet. We've, like, ranked up once already, almost.
Almost.
This is a good thing to have, like, two things going on at once. We'll do Bastok.
Intertwined. With treasures. Yeah, that's a good idea. In case one of them is making us wait.
It's happening a lot lately, so let's be on the safe side. I miss my ninja boots, man.
I also like my ninja boots. My ranger has trotter boots, but you won't let me wear them.
Well, it's not fair. You're like, you're gone.
That's
I'm like,
true.
Where are you?
Where'd you go?
We both need boots. Like, my ninja always had them, but I never wore them because you weren't ninja with me. But since you're ninja with me, it's kind of cool we both can do it.
Yeah, definitely.
Ah, you're back. Let's see it. Red. As I thought. And a very strong reaction, too. Then we should be able to use it. But we must make sure to minimize the ecological repercussions of such work. Busy as always, Chief. He looks cool, too.
Yeah, he does.
Volker, you old dog. When did you get back? Just recently, sir. I had business in the metalworks today, so I thought I'd drop by.
You must have some great stories to tell. Come on. Out with them. Chief, were you not speaking to the person before I interrupted? Oh, right, sorry. It's been a long time since he and I had a chance to talk. Let me introduce myself. I'm Volker, captain of the Mithril Musketeers. You must be an adventurer and new to Bastok, too. Are you not? I hope you do well. Bastok is in need of good people. Yeah, for your second mission, you've done very well. I'll tell the guard at the gatehouse myself. Well, I should be going. I'll drop by again later, Chief. I must go lend an ear to the President's gripes again. Come on, he needs support, especially from you. It might not look like it, but I'm sure he's doing the best. I'm sorry to have kept you here so long. Thanks again, and good work. Oh, and I might need your help again soon, so stay in touch.
Okay, back to Mines 1, and we'll accept the next mission, Fetichism, or Fetichism?
Fetichism.
Fetichism?
Fetichism.
Fetichism.
I have a fetishism.
A fetishism.
It has something to do with Mithras. You don't want to know.
That's better than Quentin Tarantino's fetish with feet.
Bastok what again? I'm sorry.
Mine's one.
Oh. I got distracted by feet and Mithras.
Right.
Gets all confuzzled up there. Crystal Caboodle. That's a good Super Koopa power.
I think that means crystals drop more often right now.
I think so.
And Swift Shoes means if you rest, you'll run faster, which we probably should do.
Yeah, we probably should. Almost a new day. Let's finish Fetish first, though.
Yeah, then we'll be ranked 2.
Fetishism. The Palboro Mines, once our main source of Mithril, have been under Beastmen control for some time. We want you to hunt these beastmen, the Quadov, and bring back a fetish head, torso, arms, and legs as proof of your accomplishments. I'm getting burpy myself. We just ate food and I keep talking. And you must present all 4 items to me or one of my colleagues in order to complete the mission. Check the auction house first.
That's what I'm doing right now.
It might be empty. There's hardly anybody out there killing things anymore. But in the retail, it's not a big deal. It won't drop twice. Unless you both need it.
There is 1 arms available, so I will buy it. And then we'll only need 7 items instead of 8.
Oh, man. We're... You got Thief? You subbing Thief?
I will...
Or at least bring the treasure
hunter. I'll bring out all of my treasure hunter trusts.
Yeah. The TH okay. crew.
My TH crew. Yeah, that's what I've got it named on my macro list is Trust TH.
There you go.
Let's see if we have the Powerball Mines one, and if we don't, we'll use that guy in Juno to teleport us there.
Should have a book there.
No, there's a crystal there, but I don't know if we've touched it yet on this character.
I thought we did. Yeah, I have it.
Yep, Gustaberg.
We were there for some reason. Maybe the dragon fight. We might have went to Bastok to fight it.
We might have.
Maybe. We should have all of them now. Maybe. Maybe not. Sandoria.
We fought the Sandoria dragon last time.
Do we have Windurst?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Ah, we have them all then.
I think we have them all.
Alright, it's time to kick ass and chew bubble gum, and I'm all out of gum.
Alright, my Trust TH crew.
How much did you pay that fetish?
2,000.
2,000? Used to be like 200 back in the day.
Oh, I know.
You buy them all. It used to be the easiest quest, as long as people are selling it.
Yep.
On private servers, this quest kind of sucks because the item can drop like more than once.
Oh, yeah, so you'll get, like, 10 heads in a row.
Yeah.
And not what you need.
Kind of like the clerks, where it's like, 10 in a row?
37 in a row?
Lechanta, you know, in the parking lot. Oh man, this is... You're gonna mess them up.
Oh yeah. Old style.
Old style. I want everyone's names written down. While we're farming, I can play that so people know what the hell we're talking about.
You should.
Hold on a second. That one is,
Peggy. Is that what it's called?
I forgot the name of the video. And there's Peggy Forever. Which one is that from? I bet I can find it. Oh, oops. I bet I can find it. I think it's Duke Nukem. Pretty sure it's Duke Nukem. I mean, 11.
Excuse me? Who the heck is this?
I've got balls of steel.
Balls of steel? What is that?
What is that?
Hello? What is that? Hello?
It's time to kick ass and chew bubble gum. And I'm all out of gum.
Okay, get off the vent or I'll have you bent.
Oh. Have you bent.
I've got balls of steel.
That's interesting.
That's interesting.
You have just been banned from the vent server. And
blow it out your ass.
Blow it out your ass.
Hold on 1 minute.
That was not me. Somebody's playing a joke on someone again. Blow it out your ass.
Blow it out your ass.
You think that's fucking funny? Do you fucking think I'm fucking laughing?
She loses it.
Balls of steel.
I got balls of steel.
Are you gonna stay here or are you gonna leave?
I've got balls of steel.
This is from 2007, by the way.
Okay, that's nice.
Balls of steel.
Balls of steel.
Steel. Balls of steel.
There's one.
There has to be somebody from the guild or somebody that we know.
Oh, I hope not, because I don't think your mother's very happy about it.
I don't think your mother's very happy.
I want every person name written down.
That's what I was quoting.
I've got balls of steel.
I got balls of steel.
I've got balls of steel. I've got balls of steel.
I'll
rip your head off and shit down your neck.
Oh, man.
Fuck off.
Eat shit and die.
Your it's
mother,
so mad.
You fucking freak. I swear to fucking God, when I find you, I'll rip your fucking head off and I'll be your goddamn boy, right? Get the
blow
fuck
it out
off.
Your ass. I've got balls of steel.
Pull it out your ass.
I'm gonna beat the shit out of your fucking mother that gave birth to you, you fucking motherfucker. You just watch when I find your goddamn ass. I'm gonna rip your fucking balls and
I think she scared everyone in their guild.
Yeah. They're like, your mom's not very happy.
Your mom's kind
of
crazy.
You piece of shit. I'm gonna make you a faggot when I find your goddamn ass.
Whoa.
Balls, 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 balls.
Balls, balls, balls.
I got
balls of steel.
Balls of steel.
It only does it when you talk.
It only does it when you talk.
I'm serious about that.
I'm gonna get you.
Blow it out your ass.
It only does it when you talk.
So you sure you don't want to switch channels?
No, I'm finding the Zara. We're gonna cut off the vent, and it's only gonna be given to certain people after this.
It's time to kick ass and chew bubble gum. And I'm all out of gum.
And you are a lot of cum also.
So whoa.
Balls of steel.
But perfect. Balls of steel.
This is you. I promise
balls. Balls.
Who is that bitch? Did you see what they wrote on vent?
They did?
In parentheses, who is that bitch?
Oh, snap. Oh, God. That's bad messed up. That's somebody who knows my mom's then. It has to be.
Oh, the spy, though. Remember, she thinks somebody's spying on her.
Yeah, it has to be a spy from her guild that she's in right now. But come on, that's hilarious. You don't think that's hilarious?
But come on, honestly, that's hilarious.
He sounds like Pedro.
He does sound like
Pedro.
I'm reporting this right now, so everyone off vent now, and I want to list the names of everyone that's on Lord of the Rings right now.
Everyone
and,
that's on Lord of the Rings.
Oh, Lord of the Rings. That's adorable.
Balls of steel.
Knock off your vent.
Got balls of steel.
Bunch of nerds.
And then he left. I went on to
I got balls of steel.
Blow it out your ass.
He's so mean to her.
No,
because it got such a reaction.
I know.
Everyone is
blow it out your ass.
Okay, get on, officer.
Congratulations, I just found out who you are.
Sorry.
I've got balls of steel.
In the headset or like
blow it out your ass. Headset.
You're dead.
I've got balls of steel.
You're dead.
What the fuck do you say, you fucking bastard?
Eat shit and die.
No, I'm gonna fucking kill you, motherfucker!
Oh, man. Oh.
You fucking watch
old prick. Style.
Old style.
Blow it out your ass.
Blow it out your ass.
Rip your head off and shit down your neck.
It goes on for way too long, too.
Yes, blow way too long.
It's only 5 minutes, but it feels like it goes on forever.
Alone,
I've got balls of steel.
Hello?
Blow it out your ass.
And he takes her voice and prank calls other people with her voice.
Yes.
I'll do that one he's next if we don't have
again.
Enough.
I get chills again. Write his name
I got
again.
Chills again.
I've got balls of steel.
Classic, man. If you've never seen these, go watch them. It's called Mr. Video Compiler. There's also another guy who does it, too.
Oh, I thought it was just called Vent Harassment.
Well, it's that, but different people do. There's like two or three people that did it, and the other ones aren't very good.
Oh, okay.
You have to watch out. Ventertainment is another good one, I think. Now, here's the Peggy Forever. He prank calls as Peggy.
Hello?
Hello.
Excuse me? Who the heck is this?
Who is this?
Okay, well, who is this?
Get off vent or I'll have you bent.
Excuse me, this is
Excuse
my
me,
vent
this
server.
This is our vent.
This is our vent server.
Name written down for the guild.
Who is this?
I'm reporting this right now, so everyone.
I'm reporting this right
now.
Now, and I want to list the names of everyone that's on right now.
Are you sure you put the right info in?
I think you're on the wrong vent server.
No, I'm finding.
No. I think you're on the wrong vent server.
It's only going to be given to certain people after this.
You can't ban anybody. You don't have. You don't have the capabilities. This is not your vent server.
You've just been banned.
No, I haven't.
No, I haven't.
No.
Man.
This is my vent
Fuck you!
Whoa.
Whoever you are, this is my vent server, and leave.
And leave.
Not only are you abusive, but we don't want you here, so...
Not only are you abusive...
You can't say that, because I have globally muted
you're
you
abusive.
Because it's my server. So whoever you are, go the hell away.
Yeah, he has, like, a good voice.
Yeah, he did. He had, like an announcer voice.
Yeah.
No, I'm a fucking
that was pretty amusing.
You, motherfucker, old style.
Oh, my God.
You fucking watch,
you
prank!
You just
gotta
mute
her.
Whoa, whoa,
whoa. Whoa.
Yeah, that's kind of funny.
Whoa. Good lord, man.
Good lord, man.
That's a switch.
What the fuck?
Are you on crack, Peggy?
Are you on crack, Peggy?
Think I'm fucking laughing?
Somebody's on crack.
Address.
I'm gonna beat the shit out of your fucking mother that gave birth to
you. Whoa!
You motherfucker. Get the fuck off my goddamn
this is
bed,
funny.
Piece of shit. I'm gonna make you a faggot when I find your goddamn
ass.
Your mama's
on
crack,
mom.
Your mother, you.
All right, everybody, be quiet.
Yes, I'm sure you're a motherfucker too. Shut the fuck up.
He is really causing a commotion here.
Yes.
Whoever you are, look at your vent settings. They're wrong.
You're dead.
I'm sorry it took so much intelligence for you to look at a fucking number, but shut the fuck up and look at it. You're on the wrong damn vents.
I'm gonna get you.
Man, she got some problems, man.
She got some problems, man.
She loves your comedy.
Yeah.
Oh my god, that's so funny.
You're going bye-bye, sweetheart.
Leave me alone!
Nobody's bothering
leave
you.
Me alone!
Us. Okay, let's let Evan do what he needs to do to get us back on track, so we'll go ahead and keep playing.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with that, but it's wrong vent server.
I'll be right back.
I'll be right back.
I'll be right back. No, you won't.
You know, you really should take anger management class, lady.
No, I'm gonna fucking kill you, motherfucker!
Old style.
How about just offing yourself and fucking making the world a better place?
Whoa.
Whoa.
How about you kill yourself?
You just watch when I find your goddamn ass.
Lady, if you could find me,
go get your razor.
I'm so sorry.
Find your wrist.
Are you sure she's anybody's friend just fucking around?
No,
that ain't
like
fucking
she's...
around, man.
Like I hope he's fucking around, man.
God, you major messed up.
You recognize
his
voice?
I would recognize the voice, yes.
Really?
Really?
Well, yes, I do.
Pointer?
Pointer?
He's starting again.
Excuse me, but my 13-year-old son is in this van, and I don't appreciate the language and
yeah, right.
that you're using.
Fuck you!
So you need to go away.
His time is genius.
It's perfect,
why
yes.
How do you even
do
that on time?
Yeah.
Well, I think she has a sexy voice.
What's up with that guy?
Hello?
I hope you go to hell, lady.
Ooh.
Fuck you!
This is somebody else's vent. We've been using this for months. How did you get this vent server?
Congratulations, I just found out who you are.
Congratulations.
Sexy Peggy.
Pointer? He's starting again. I got chills again. Write his name down again.
Aww. Write his name down again.
Hold on a second, guys. Let me log on their website.
You killed
and
everything,
IP
didn't
address,
we?
Please.
Yes.
I want to find who the hell she is in game. And
I have two pieces.
Yeah.
I have head and arms.
Don't you have some friends to go bother?
Oh my god, no.
I have three. Head, arms, legs. Which one's your favorite vent harassment?
I like the one where they found a ring in there last night.
Yeah, that was
it was bouncing off the moon.
Yeah, that was a nerd.
That was my favorite.
That one's called vent harassment nerd something. The World of Warcraft nerd. Or World of Nerdcraft. Spelled that wrong. It's nerd confusion. The ring. Yeah, this is Ventertainment. He's the one that had like Tom Cruise's picture as a profile picture.
Oh yeah, yeah.
This had 1.8 million views.
Oh my gosh.
It's worth it. I went down, down, down. Yeah, it's called Nerd Confusion 3, The Ring.
Hey, you know what? I need to go to Black Fathom Deep's BFD, because there's two drops on pants in there.
Oh, I love these guys.
I do too.
The bosses you're talking about, is it the last two bosses that you're looking for?
They're really cool guys, too.
Yes.
He's in like a little
and they don't get mad like Peggy.
No, they just laugh.
I got a ring in there last night.
They're all drinking beers, having a good time.
I don't know why that just said that, because I said that like 5 minutes ago.
He keeps repeating one of that one guy.
What the hell?
We're getting feedback from outer space.
Feedback from outer space.
Got lost somewhere in vent.
It bounced off the moon.
It bounced
off the moon.
I got a ring in there last night. Did you hear that? There it goes
again.
Yeah, he keeps repeating, I got a ring in there last night.
Why is it bouncing around like that?
How's it bouncing around like that?
There was just a flagged ally and a horde fighting here a second ago.
I got a ring in there last night.
There it goes again.
Yeah,
you hear that?
That wasn't me saying it again.
I mean, that's weird.
I got a ring in there last night. Damn, there it is again.
You got a ring in there last night.
No idea.
That is freaking weird.
Gosh, I must be awful proud of that ring. I won't shut up about it.
I won't shut up about it. These guys are the best sports of all the videos.
Yes.
They're so funny.
Oh, that's wild.
You might want to get close to me at this point.
Oh,
you might want to get close to me at this
that.
Point.
He repeats that. I got a ring in there last night.
I got a ring in there last night.
Now, how the hell does it keep doing that?
No idea.
That is freaky. Hey, Carl, you got a ring in there last night.
Hey, Carl, you got a ring in there last night.
Sounds like I must have got five of them.
Drop your pants.
Drop
your pants.
That ain't me saying that either.
That's weird.
That's weird.
It's the aliens.
It's the aliens.
Twilight
Zone. Okay. I want you to stay in the water, and I'm going to go down here and start clearing. You won't.
I got a ring in there last night.
Okay, I'll stay in the water.
Well, if you stay in the water, you should be okay there.
All right.
I'm going to put the pet on crazy.
I got a ring in there last night.
Did you get a ring?
No, doing it more often. Weird shit only happens to me.
I've never seen it do that.
I got a ring in there last night.
Yeah. I wonder if I got to get off vent and get back on. Let me try
that. Yeah, I'm sure that's it.
I got a ring in there last night. God damn it.
I'm going to turn vent totally off and start it up.
Okay.
Yeah, that'll fix it.
Yeah, maybe I corrected it.
Turn it off and on again.
It didn't work.
It didn't work.
Drop your pants.
Drop your pants.
Drop your pants. I got a ring in there last night.
Oh my god.
It's getting worse.
Okay, I reconnected to you. I thought maybe it was me.
I got a ring in there last night.
This is going to really get annoying, isn't it? Now, I'm going to tell you what, that tells me everything set on vent can be trapped and kept in cyberspace here, guys.
That's right.
That's true.
Somewhere.
I shut vent off, I've done all that, reloaded it, nothing's doing any different. Oh, cat jumped in the water and nailing something down here.
Uh-oh, he got his laughter.
There's that going, too.
Uh-oh, that going.
No. Jeez.
Tell you what, this is bad. Too bad we ain't stoned out of our gourds.
These guys are cool.
Listen to this tonight. I'm afraid to say anything on that now.
Well, it seems like I quit now a little bit.
Yeah.
I would totally hang out with these guys.
Right.
Somewhere along here.
I got four.
I got a ring in there last night. I
have three.
It ain't gonna just go away. That one really stuck.
That's really stuck.
That's me dropping my pants.
That's dropping my pants. Got a ring in there last night.
Got me a beer so I can put up with this. You might want to get close to me at this point. Like pulling on a
You're gonna want to get close to me at this point.
Right. You might want to get close to me at this point. Annoying as hell. You might want to get close to me at this point. Drop your pants.
Drop your pants.
I can just see it coming. You might want to get close to me at this point. Drop your pants. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Yo. What's up,
Welcome
butters?
To the Twilight Zone.
Hey, Goku.
You're going to hear me saying stuff that I'm not saying.
I dropped my pants.
Don't start it, heavy. Don't go there. Drop your pants.
Drop
oh,
your
shit.
Pants.
Damn it.
Very nice job, Butters.
The damn vent's all screwed up.
We don't know what the hell's going on.
It's got segments of what I've said and it keeps repeating them over and over again. I keep getting this damn ring and he keeps dropping his pants.
He's dropping his pants.
I've seen vent do some screwy shit, but nothing like this.
Well, Butters, you are gifted.
You ever anything like this happen on vent before, Goku?
Never.
It's just you. You got one more shot here. We got the last boss that can do it. You might want to get close to me at this point. Yeah, you got a fart.
Yeah, I got a fart. Uh-oh.
Oh, shoot. They're all around you. Come to me. Yeah, you got a fart. Oh, no. I recorded that.
How does it do that?
That's not the moon.
You might want to get close to me at this point. Yeah, you got a fart. Oh, no.
Look at that, huh? Get close to you and drop my pants.
You
might want to get close to me at this point.
Want to drop your pants? I got a ring in there last night.
What the hell? I just thought I'd let you know. No, I have no control of this.
Want to drop your pants? I'm going up in here.
You two-houred.
Yep.
I'm going up in there.
I'm going up in there.
I got a ring in there last night.
I've never heard it do nothing like that. Nothing.
Yeah, but how does it get recorded like that to keep doing it?
Yeah, I think it's bouncing off the moon or something.
Hey.
Hey.
Nice. Here's some blue pants you might want to look at real
Those hands
fast.
Are awful. See that? Negative
I saw three. That. Negative three evasion?
I think so.
That's the ones. Dark weave britches. Sweet.
I like how we're very meta. We're playing an MMO as they play an MMO, as we make fun of the MMO.
Right.
I bet you could.
And then I can drop them, and I can stay close to you, and you can go up in there.
You can go up in there.
I'll have to get that out. That is terrible.
They're such good sports about it.
I know. This is the only one that everyone just kind of like had it, like, went along with it. Not getting annoyed.
Yeah, well, yeah, Peggy was going to go on a serial killer spree.
Peggy was the most pissed off. For sure.
Yeah, I might need it on the vent.
1 hour later.
I got
later.
A ring in there last night.
There you go.
I wish you was on doing that. I got to tell you. A freaking hour later, you come back on bragging about your freaking ring.
It's like an hour later.
Yeah, the original guy's gone now.
Want to drop your pants? Going up in.
That's just his friends. They're just laughing at him.
I really enjoyed that.
He really enjoyed it.
He really enjoyed it. The end. Good stuff, man.
Yes, it is.
Well, that was Event harassment. We should definitely play more of that in the future.
Mm-hmm.
They are super funny. There's a lot of good ones. I like the Halloween one where the girl, it plays the Halloween theme music, and she has
from Halloween Season of the Witch.
Yeah, and she like says, it reminds me when I was on shrooms.
And it's like Silver Shamrock.
And it's hilarious. This one guy's talking to her, he's always eating. Like, I just ate a whole thing of mac and cheese and I'm still hungry.
No, he says, I'm still not satisfied.
Yeah, I'm still not satisfied. That's right. That's great. There's some good ones out there. Or the whistles go, woo, woo.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one, too. Okay, give him all four fetish.
Oh, my bad. Ah. Good. You've brought all four parts of the doll. I am raising your rank to 2 for completing this mission. Congratulations. If you've been to the Pulborough Mines, you must know now the serious nature of the threat these beastmen pose to our civilization. As a Bastalker, you are expected to take on more missions and go on conquest to preserve Bastalk's brilliant future. But I cannot give you a new mission at this time. You need to collect rank points before taking on new missions. You can receive rank points by participating in conquest and donating the crystals you acquire to guards, or by undertaking missions you've previously completed. Ask the High Guard near the gatehouse if you wish to hear more about conquest. Rank deuce. Welcome back. How was your battle with the Quadov? Sir Iron Eater, what brings you to this area? So, what is the situation with the Mines District? Sir, nothing out of the ordinary, sir. This is getting the trust, isn't it? For Iron Eater.
No, I think we already have him.
That's weird. I don't know this. Spare me the textbook answers. That is not what I asked. You know what I speak of. The disappearance of Werei. Yes, sir, I've heard that he was your mentor, and that he was undertaking his journey of rebirth. My condolences. It is said that he took his life while on a journey of rebirth. I did not come here to be told that I already know. I am concerned with the fear of residents along Orr Street. Yes, sir, my apologies, sir. We will double our efforts to gather any information. Understood. I apologize for my temper. Was that part of the story, or is that like...
Well, it must be, but I don't remember ever seeing it before.
Me neither. For someone once known as the Immovable Rock, it is unusual to see him so angered. Once a Galka, always a Galka. I guess they have a bond that we humans will never understand. That's part of the story.
Ooh, 1,000 gil.
Yeah, we're rich.
Mm-hmm. Might as well trade some crystals to Crying Wind while we're here. I'll get some out of my case. Do you have some or need some?
I got plenty. You know, one stack will fill them up. Back to treasures, right?
Sure.
Unless you're wanting to call it for the night.
We can finish that mission we were on at treasures.
Yeah, we've been playing for about an hour, plus about 20 minutes yesterday, so about almost an hour and 30 minutes now.
Cool. Yeah,
not bad.
We can finish this mission. It's just one more cutscene to finish this mission, and then we can watch TV.
We had some fun times. I was in a good mood today.
Yeah, me too.
We had opposite roles. You got on me for talking too loud, and yesterday I got on you for talking too loud. So we can't co-align with our good moods, I guess.
Oh, I'm still in a great mood. It was just when you were laughing at one point, it was really loud in my headset.
Oh, my bad. I forget that we're communicating via headset.
Yeah.
But it's important, though, because they're noise-canceling, so if you didn't hear yourself, you'd be yelling.
That's true.
You can't hear yourself talk.
During the cutscene, it will ask us a choice, and the correct choice is Afmau.
All right. Sounds good.
Well, well, if it isn't Noxian Rewind, keeping your nose to the grindstone? You betcha.
You betcha.
Glad to hear it. Maybe you do have what it takes to be a Salahim Sentinel's employee after all. But enough of that. You want to hear something strange? Recently, I've been floating on a cloud of calm, and I'm sure you're aching to know why. You see, the company earnings have finally begun to live up to my expectations, and it's about time. Those days and nights of painfully building up a reputation for my budding enterprise have finally paid off. I can sense that the universe is rewarding me for my effort. Things are going to be okay from now on. I'm certain of it. I'm even starting to think about showing some gratitude toward my faithful employees. La la la.
Rewind. Rewind. Over here. Love him.
Me too.
Ever since the Wendershin ambassador left, President Najah's been completely focused. Nothing but work, work, and more work. Her head's been filled with nothing but the sound of clinking coins. Her dedication to the running of this business is even more pathological than usual. So now, seeing President Najah in this tranquil state is unsettling to say the least. So, she barely registers the existence of anyone around her when she gets like this. Oh? Was there something you wish to discuss with the president? For I, Abakuba, am here to answer all your queries and doubts. I feel I owe you a favor, after all. Now, what's on your mind, Rewind?
Afmau.
Afmau? Uh-oh. Oh dear, oh dear. President Najah, President Najah!
What? How many times do I gotta tell you not to yell in my ear like that?
I have neglected to bring a very important matter to your attention. My most humble apologies.
Well, what do we have here? A gilded envelope stamped with the seal of the two-headed serpent. Signed in the hand of the Grand Vizier. addressed to Noxie. You've been singled out by the palace again. Do you mind if I take a quick look at this? Oh ho. Did you show up today because you had a feeling this would be arriving?
That's right.
That's right. I've had just about enough of your wisecracking. This here letter is a personal summons from the Grand Vizier Rozvad himself. We've come up in the world now, haven't we, Miss Private Second Class? From the looks of it, His Excellency requires your presence pronto. You know what you gotta do. Then why are you still here? Are you trying to bring the wrath of the entire palace down upon us? Are you trying to get cut into our new profit margin? Are you? I've worked too hard to have this company's reputation ruined by the likes of you. Now scat!
Is that it for tonight?
Sounds good. We have beat mission... We beat mission 23, 24, and 25 on this stream.
And Bastlock 1.
And Bastlock 1.
It's crazy. It feels like we've done a lot, but we really didn't. That was a lot of fun, though.
It was a lot of fun.